Make sure I've got the right ingredients before I heat up the pan. I take a little bit of bitterness to grease it up and keep everything close at hand. Then I add a few ounces of fresh frustration and half a cup of attitude. A rush of adrenaline to spice things up and then half a spoon of bad mood. One bottle of my sweat, one bottle of tears, a few drops of my own blood. It all blends together like a cat and a dog, and the result is as clear as mud. I pick the worst situation out of a bunch before we ride into the mix. And last but not least, I add a little bit of spit, just a few little nasty clicks. That's a recipe for hate. That's a recipe for hate. I turn up the heat to 400 degrees and go to work on the attitude. I shake it all up in a provocative way to make sure that it comes out rude. And then I grind down the frustration hard so that all of the sense can blend. I pour the sweat on top and then the tears to make sure that I don't make friends. When the mood is wrong, if the fin is right, I can add the adrenaline. But I got to be careful with the dose I use, the effect shouldn't wear too thin. The buck comes last, cause it always has a tendency to cool and coagulate. So I calculate and make no mistakes, it's so fresh that it's no false face. That's a recipe for hate. That's a recipe for hate. When the meal is done, you get a spoiled appetite and a dish full of disarray. So make the runs on the side, a plate full of hate, served with a fistful of meat. That's a recipe for hate. A recipe for hate.